Children, today we are taking another topic of business study from chapter 1, and the topic is objectives of management. So under this topic we have three types of objectives, namely organizational objectives, personal objectives, and the third one is social objectives. So under organizational objectives we have three types of objectives, namely survival, number two profit, and number three is growth. The first point is survival. If we want to keep our business alive for a very long period, it is very important to earn sufficient amount of profit. If we are able to earn sufficient amount of profit, when the business is able to cover its cost, then the business will survive for a long period. So for the survival of the business, it is very important to earn sufficient amount of profit. Then the second point is profit. As you know that the main objective of business is to earn reasonable amount of profit. The amount of profit should not be very high. The amount of profit should not be very low. The businessman should always try to earn reasonable amount of profit. If the businessman is charging higher amount of prices from the customer, so there may be chances when the customer may not repeat the order. And if the businessman charges low amount of profit, then the business may not be able to cover its cost of production. So the reasonable amount of profit should be charged by the businessman from the customers. And the third point is growth. Every business does not want to confine itself to a limited area. The businessman always wants to expand its business. The business wants to expand the market. The business wants to create new customer also. So if the business wants to expand, so for the expansion and growth of the business also, we need profit. Because with the help of profit, we are able to grow our business and we are able to expand our business. So these were some of the organizational objectives without which the business will not be able to survive, or business will not be able to run for a long period. And the next point is personal objectives. See, first of all, we should try to understand the meaning of personal objective. Personal objective means that those objectives or those requirements which are satisfied by the businessman for the employees in the organization. As we know that employees are the pillar of our organization, if we have physical resources like machinery, tools, etc., and if we have financial resources like money, etc., but if we do not have satisfied workforce, we will not be able to survive for a long period. So we should try to understand the requirement, the taste and liking of the employees in the organization if we really want to survive for a long period. So under this we have three types of objectives. The first point is good salary and perks. Good amount of salary, reasonable amount of salary should be given to employees in the organization, and for this purpose we can compare the salary of our organization with the salary in the neighboring industries so that the labor turnover is reduced. And perks. Perk means that other than wages and salary, that there are so many benefits which should be provided to the workers, to the employees in the organization. They should be given DNS allowance also, they should be given medical allowance also, they should be provided children fees facility also. So these are some of the objectives, these are some of the allowances which must be provided to by the businessman to the employees in the organization. And then comes opportunities for promotion. Every employee in the organization wants promotion. So after a certain period of time, with the help of their experience, with their knowledge, with their qualification, with their experience, they should be promoted to the higher post. Because when they are promoted, they feel confident, they feel motivated, and they also find themselves in a position to handle new responsibilities and new duties. Then comes personal growth and development. When a worker joins an institution, he is given training periodically, because with the help of training, he is able to do his work more skillfully, and he learns more, and he understands how to deal with different situations. So, with his personal growth and development, the employee in the organization or the worker in the organization is able to handle new and diverse problems. So, personal growth and development should also be there in the organization for the employees. Then comes social objectives. As we know that society is an important part. Whatever we take from the society, it's our duty also that we should give something back to the society. So, under these objectives, we have some objectives. The first one is supply of quality goods at reasonable prices. Because we are taking many things, almost everything from the society, so this is the objective of the business, to provide quality goods to the society. We should not provide them some substandard products. We should provide the best product available for them and at reasonable price. As I discussed you earlier, we should not try to charge higher amount of profit. We should not charge lower amount of profits. We should always try to take reasonable amount of profit so that we could make our customer a permanent customer. And then comes employment opportunities. As you know that there are so many economic problems in our country. So one of them is unemployment. So when the business flourishes, the businessman is able to provide more and more employment facilities to the unemployed people in our country. So this is also one of the objectives with the help of which the businessman is able to fulfill his social responsibilities. And then comes to protection of environment. So the businessman should always produce the goods with such technique, we should not pollute our atmosphere, we should not pollute our environment. And nowadays, there are very good techniques of packaging also. So the goods can be packed easily without imbalancing our environment. So these are some of the social objectives which a businessman should fulfill. So, now you see these are the main objectives which a businessman should fulfill for the employees of the organization, for the society and for its own survival. So, if the businessman takes care about all the three objectives, the business will be able to survive for a long period and the business will be able to earn profit in the long run, the business will be able to expand, the business will be able to grow. So, this was the second topic of business study, which is related to our first chapter. The name of the first chapter is Nature and Significance of Management. In the previous lecture, we had discussed about the meaning of management and some of the features or attributes of management. And this is the second topic of management, and its name is Objectives of Management. And our third lecture will be on importance of management, because whenever we do something, we have some importance. So those importance, those points will be discussed in the next video. Thank you so much. Please keep in touch with me, and whatever videos are uploaded, so I humbly request each one of you to kindly go through, to listen to them and try to do something so that there should not be any loss to any child due to this holidays and due to this coronavirus outbreak. Thank you so much. So nice of you.